is a small kingdom in the Himalayas, known for its beautiful scenery, beautiful people and beautiful landscapes. Bhutan is truly one of the happiest countries in the world, where gross national happiness is more important than the gross national product. It was called the land of happiness. Bhutan's capital city, Thimphu, is perhaps best known as the only capital in the world without a traffic light. The official arrival of television in the country did not occur until 1999, and the first road was not constructed until 1962. Bhutan, it would appear, is a country of little global significance. Wedged into the Himalayas between two regional giants, India and China, it is an isolated and mountainous country inhabited by less than 1 million people. The country has few resources in demand by the global economy and was largely closed off to the outside world until 1960. But Bhutan is significant. It was found that 91% of Bhutanese citizens are happy, while nearly 50% of people are deeply or extensively satisfied. The term gross national happiness was coined in 1972 when the late Rajiv Gandhi, the then Prime Minister of India, declared that gross national happiness was more important than gross domestic product. Since then, the idea of gross national happiness has not only influenced the country's economic and social policies, but has also captured the imagination of others far beyond its borders. Jigme Singye Wangchuk, Bhutan's fourth king, coined the phrase gross national happiness and famously declared gross national happiness is more important than gross national product. The concept of gross national happiness, or GNH, articulate an understanding of development that moves beyond economic growth and incorporates multiple and interrelated social, economic, cultural, environmental, and government dimensions. It is an attempt to construct the development in a holistic manner that addresses the multiple dimensions of being human. Bhutan has made significant development gains since the inauguration of GNH as its national development strategy. GNH is also gaining significant international traction as an applied model of multidimensional development. In 2011, the United Nations designated Bhutan to lead the design of an international happiness-focused development paradigm. The result of Bhutan's efforts ultimately helped shape the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. Bhutan may be tiny, but its outsized influence has put it at the forefront of putting multidimensional development approach into action. The growing international profile of gross national happiness speaks to its importance as an applied model of multidisciplinary development. However, a curious situation does exist. International enthusiasm is not matched by a clear understanding of the factors that drive the actual implementation of GNH within Bhutan itself. Conceptually, GNH is intriguing, but operationally, its key drivers remain largely unknown. This is a critical issue as GNH is implemented by multiple and fragmented Bhutanese governance actors with competing political interests and development priorities. How does Bhutan put multidimensional GNH policies into action on ground? Do competing interests impact the implementation process, and if so, how are they governed? Is it even accurate to speak of Bhutan's development outcomes as being driven from GNH? Answering them is further necessary if you to access whether Bhutan's experience offers insights for the effective governance of human development more broadly. The growing international appeal of GNH is rooted in the global development community's increasing turn to multidimensional approaches like the human development paradigm. Happiness, though, has somewhat complicated relationship with human development. Both the happiness approach and human development are multidimensional development strategies that move beyond the traditional focus of economic growth. Yet some remain wary of engaging happiness as a part of human development, while others see synergies and still embrace them. Key differences involve the ultimate ends of each approach as well as the nature of measurement. However, in the context of governance and the practical applications on ground, the two are highly connected. Human development and its accompanying measuring tool, the Human Development Index, have become a dominant development paradigm promoted by the United Nations Development Programme. The paradigm draws heavily on the capability approach developed by Amartya Sen, Martha Nussbaum, and others by conceptualizing development as increasing people's freedoms to choose meaningful lives. Practically, it focuses on creating enabling conditions that promote the social, economic, environmental, cultural, and governance conditions that allow the Bhutanese to choose happy lives. The GNH framework, which conceptualizes happiness not in the Western notion of an individual's often fleeting subjective happiness, but as more foundational condition rooted in Buddhism with inheritance ties to others and the environment. GNH creates conditions for individual and the society to freely pursue this kind of happiness. The Bhutanese government firmly firmly believes that the Gross National Happiness Index reports more accurately and in depth on the well-being of the nation as a whole, which is more important than any other method. This declaration has triggered changes in the world, as standards other than GDP were once used to measure well-being, and a revolutionary statement has been made that gross national happiness was more important than gross national product. Analyzing Bhutan's governance, experience, and the process of implementing GNH on the ground can provide insight into the implementation of applied human development strategies elsewhere. Well, that's all for this video. We hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to Explified. Also, do press the bell icon. Bye!